Good morning, everyone. I am Sarah Innamorato. I proudly represent the 21st Legislative District in Pittsburgh and Northern Allegheny County. And I'm grateful for everyone who came out today and grateful for the Pennsylvania Budget and Policy Center for shining a light on the housing crisis in Pennsylvania. But housing policy has been a focus of our office since I was elected in 2018. The release of this report contains pages upon pages of statistics and stories that show that Harrisburg must take legislative action to secure dignified, healthy, and affordable homes for all Pennsylvanians. But policymaking, it's about the combination of the head, white papers like this with the stats and the data, and the heart, like sharing lived experiences on what it means to have a home. The latter is what drives my work in this space. See, I'm a daughter of a father with a substance use disorder, and there were times in my life where I was in crisis. I remember one afternoon getting off the bus and seeing my mom in the driveway. She told me she had packed a few things for my sister and I, and we'd be leaving. I learned housing is not a guarantee in America at that moment, even if you live in a middle-class suburban home. I spent my teenage years sleeping on people's couches, sharing a bed with my sister and mom, and constantly moving. This transient time made finding a place to call home a dream that I aspired to. And I found that in a neighborhood called Lawrenceville, which is my home. After renting for 8 years, I was able to save enough to qualify for a Federal Housing Administration mortgage that allowed me to purchase a naturally occurring affordable alleyway home that was aligned with my nonprofit salary I was making at the time. See, Pittsburgh is often looked at one of the few remaining enclaves of affordable living in the United States. However, average housing prices in my neighborhood have quadrupled in the last decade, while property taxes continue to increase and average wages remain stagnant. And even before the COVID-19 pandemic, as a state representative, I've heard over and over shared stories from both postgraduates, renters, and aging seniors who fear displacement from rising rent and rising property taxes. I saw these changes firsthand in my neighborhood when senior citizens who used to help at community fundraisers were forced to move out of the neighborhood when an apartment complex sold. We started seeing less children from homes subsidized by housing choice vouchers coming to the free dinners and the children's program we did at our community garden. And then the COVID-19 pandemic took a delicate situation into a broken one. But this time, we had resources. The pandemic created a lot of pain, but it also gave us an unprecedented programs and interventions like the Emergency Rental Assistance Program and the eviction moratorium that showed our leaders that we can stabilize families and communities when given the tools and the funding. In Allegheny County alone, ERAP helped tens of thousands of low-income households stay in their homes and keep the lights on. 70% of those households reported a woman as the head of household, and 41% included at least one child. Overall, the largest demographic helped in Allegheny County were single mothers. These tools were not perfect, nor were they funded in a way that met the full scope of the need, but we cannot stop now. Rental assistance funding in Allegheny County is also expected to run out by late summer, priming the pump for an explosion in eviction and foreclosure filings later this year. This, coupled with the recent reports that show a year-over-year increase in rents at 20%, we must act now. We should immediately invest additional American Rescue Plan dollars in rental assistance program to help address the simmering crisis, which now threatens to boil over. But we shouldn't stop there. We need to pass long-term solutions to achieve equitable stabilization in our housing system. We can invest in developing affordable housing models that are resistant to future financializations of homes by Wall Street firms. We can raise the wage to ensure everyone can afford to live a dignified life. We can build off the ERAP program and create a long-term program to prevent traumatic evictions and so much more. Together, as legislators with our community, we have the power to act and take the steps to address the housing crisis and help our neighbors of all ages and all identities with what they need most, a place to call home.